Hello everyone, welcome back. So far, we've taught you which data types to use for temporarily storing numbers, text, and so on. But all of these types can only store a single value. To store a list of these values in a variable, what approach should we take? In programming, we utilize various data structures to store multiple values of the same data type in a variable. One of these data structures is array. In this lecture, we'll explore what is an array and learn how to utilize it. Okay, an array is a collection of values of the same type that are stored together in a contiguous memory location and identified by a single name. In other words, an array serves as a data structure that enables us to store and manage a group of elements with the same data type. As you may know from before, it provides a way to organize and access these elements using index-based notation. Okay, let's say we want to store the employee IDs of 5 employees. Without an array, we have to store them like this. As you can see, we have to declare a variable for each employee. Now, let's see how arrays solve this problem. In the following, we'll cover the syntax and rules for the declaration and initialization of arrays. But for now, let's focus only on the concept. As you can see, arrays offer a way to group related data. Okay, rather than declaring separate variables for each element, we can store them in an array, making it easier to organize and work with data collections. Alright, let's see how we can declare and initialize an array. Here, in the first statement, we declare an array named numbers that can hold int values. It specifies that the array will store elements of type int. Similarly, in the second statement, we declare an array named names that can hold string values. It indicates that the array will store elements of type string. Okay. We can initialize these arrays with a size of 4 using the new keyword followed by the data type and the desired size in square brackets. Now, each of these variables contains 4 containers filled with a default value of the array's data type. In C#, the default value of numbers is 0. While for all reference types, including a string, the default value is null. Alright, we can access the elements of an array using indexes. The indexes of arrays start from 0, which means that the first element has an index of 0. And the last element's index is equal to the size of the array subtract 1. In this case, since the array size is 4, the index of the last element in each array would be 3, which is obtained by subtracting 1 from 4. Okay, here we assign the value 11 to the first element of the numbers array, and the value Immo to the first element of the names array using index 0. Let's see the same for other indexes. As you can see, we can update each element of the array using indexes. Similarly, we can access each element using indexes. For example, we can access the second element of the names array and print it in the terminal using indexes. Alright. There are multiple ways to create and initialize an array. The elements of an array can be initialized when the array is created. As you can see, we declare the numbers array and initialized it at the same time with default values. The elements of an array can also be initialized to known values when the array is created. As you can see here, we declare the numbers array and initialize it at the same time with known values in two ways. In the second way, the value of the array is directly initialized without taking its size. So, the array size will automatically be the number of values which is directly taken. One important thing to note is that if we remove the number 14 from this array, an error will occur. This is because we're trying to initialize an array with a specified size of 4, but we're only providing 3 values. To avoid such errors, ensure that the number of values matches the size of arrays. Okay, done. See you soon with another lecture.